Hello everyone. My view is you all are safe with your family during this pandemic COVID-19. Students, let me begin with a new chapter, My Brother, My Brother. Before the lesson, let me introduce what is National Bravery Awards. Students, have you heard about the National Bravery Awards? Do you know why are these awards given? Let me explain. The National Bravery Award is a set of award given annually to about 25 Indian children below 16 years of age for meritorious acts of bravery against all odds. This award is given by Government of India and the Indian Council for Child Welfare. The first National Bravery Award was given in 1957 to Harish Chandra Mehra. Okay, so for his courage and presence of mind, Harish saved the life of the then Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru along with many other dignitaries. When fire broke out in a Shamiana due to a spark from a firework, Harish entered the burning Shamiana and started climbing the 20 feet high electric pole. On reaching the top, he whipped out his scout knife and cut off the burning Shamiana cloth. So, the first National Bravery Award was given to Harish Chandra Mehra in the year of 1957. Okay. Now, let me introduce the author of this story, My Brother, My Brother, Nora Burke. She was a novelist and non-fiction writer. She was famous for her descriptions of life in India. During the early 20th century, her autobiographical books are Jungle Child, 11 Leopards, and Midnight Forests. Okay. Now, I introduce the meanings of new words. Grocery, we say. Beaters. Beaters means people who beat drums to frighten wild animals. So we say beaters. Blazed. Blazed means shone brightly. Then brave. It means not afraid. Willing to do things which are dangerous or difficult. Expedition. It means an organized journey with a particular purpose. Glance, to look quickly at something or someone. Heralding, heralding means giving a sign that something is going to happen. Jostle, jostle means to push roughly against. Perhaps, perhaps means possibly. Photographic, it means connected with photographs or photography. Plaited. Plaited means to twist three or more pieces of something together to form a long piece. Plodded. Plodded means walk with heavy steps because of tiredness. Let me switch on next slide. Then rags. It means pieces of old and torn out clothes. Scrambled. It means move quickly but with difficult and by using your hands. Several. Several means more than two but not many. Shaggy. It means with long and untidy hair. Next, sight. Sight means a thing that you see. Snorted. Snorted means breathed noisily with nose. Breathed noisily with nose. Squeal, it means a high, long sound or cry. Steadily, steadily means going on gradually. Tusker, it means elephant, an elephant. Wreckage, wreckage means parts of vehicle, building or etc. that remain after it has been damaged. Ring, ring means to twist and squeeze. Okay. Children, today I'm going to teach you a very beautiful true life adventure story. It is about a young boy of 12 years of age who had to carry his critically ill younger brother Kunwar to a hospital at night. In the end, he succeeds his mission and earns the title of Bahadur. The whole story is about a 12 years old boy. So, let me first introduce you the main character of the story, Sher Singh. He is Sher Singh and Kunwar, a younger boy, the brother of Sher Singh, and Sher Singh's mother and a doctor. Okay, let me explain the story. My brother. Sher Singh's little brother lay in the hut with a pain in his stomach that was getting worse. Sher Singh himself was only about 12 years old, small and cheerful, a child of the jungle. His brother was several years younger. I will wring out rags in boiling water and lay them on his stomach, said his mother. She did not weep. She had lived through everything over and over again. Student, Sher Singh, a 12 years old young boy, lived in a hut in the jungle of the Laldwani village with his mother and younger brother Kunwar. What is his name? His name was Kunwar. Suddenly one day, what happens? Sher Singh's younger brother Kunwar fell ill. He became sick. He was suffering from stomach pain. Sher Singh and his mother tried a lot to cure it, but they were unsuccessful. When all the tries went in vain, his mother, without weeping, and said, he must be carried to the hospital at Khalgat. So Sher Singh's mother said that, I will wring out rags in boiling water and lay them on his stomach. Why does she say, do you know? She had a hope that if she lay a steaming rag on his stomach, it might have cured his stomach pain. The steaming rags did not help. After a while, Sher Singh's mother said he must be carried to the hospital at Khalgat. Students, this steaming rag which she laid on the Kunwar's stomach, it did not work out, or it did not cure the pain. Later, his mother said to Sher Singh that his brother must be carried to the hospital at Khalgat. So where is the hospital? The hospital is at Khalgat. So where does Sher Singh's family live? They live in the jungle. So there is no proper transport from jungle to Khalgat. Then Sher Singh thought that his brother was dying. All jungle people somehow think that the hospital is the last resort of the doomed. I will run for my father,
he cried. It may be days before you find him. The people said to him,
Sher Singh's father was away in the jungle with a photographic expedition. All the men of Laldwani village too were with the expedition as beaters. See students, looking at his brother, Sher Singh thought his brother was dying. If he doesn't take him to the hospital. So all the people of the village thought that the hospital is the last resort of the doomed. So Sher Singh told that he would run for his father to carry his brother to the hospital. And it may take long time to bring his father to the home. So, because his father was away in the jungle with a photographic expedition. So, photographic expedition means a journey or excursion undertaken for a specific or particular purpose. It's basically done by a group of people for any cinematography or movie purpose, or sometimes purpose for making the documentation of an area's landscape, people, customs or culture or history. So almost the men of the Laldwani village too were with the expedition as beaters. Okay, beaters means people who beat drums to frighten wild animals. So have you understood? Okay, next. Sher Singh looked at his younger brother and saw that he was in a great pain. See, Sher Singh looked at his younger brother and saw that he was in a great pain. So Sher Singh staring at his younger brother, and he saw that he was groaning in a great pain. He was crying and groaning in a great pain. So Kalagat was at least 50 miles away, but Sher Singh hoped that if he could get through the jungle and cross the two rivers in between, he might get a lift in a bullock cart or perhaps even a broken down truck for the last part of his journey. See students, the Kalagat was 50 miles away from his village. So do you know 1 mile equals to how many kilometers? Do you know? So 1 mile equals to 1.6 kilometers. So just 1.6 kilometers into 50 miles. Calculate it. Make it multiply. So the Kalagat was around 80 kilometers from his village. So it's so far. But Sher Singh hoped that if he could get through the jungle and cross two rivers in between, at least the Kalagat may be near to his village. He might get a lift in a bullock cart or truck for the last part of his journey. Sher Singh walked alone, carrying his brother on his back. He walked through the jungle. Night fell. The sky became purple black. It blazed with stars. Sher Singh had good eyes. He could still see. Presently, the moon rose. The sight of the bear track in the dust, the square front paw and long back one, with the shaggy claws, made him glance round uneasily. Students, so he decided to take his or to carry his brother to the hospital. So Sher Singh started his journey through the jungle, carrying his brother on his back alone. He rushed through the jungle. As he walking in the jungle to Kalagat, day became night. So the night fell. The sky became purple with stars. The sky blazed with stars. So blazed means shone brightly. So the sky shone brightly with the stars. The stars shone brightly. Shersing had good eyes. His eyes were very sharp. He can watch even in the dark. The moon rose. He can see easily. The track which was made by the bear in the dust. The square front paw and long back one with untidy claws made him look quickly round uneasily. On a cliff about a river bed, Sher Singh knew he could go no further without rest. Sweat was running off his shaking flesh. He set Kunwar down gently against the tree. Students, on a cliff above a river bed. It's a river. So it's a cliff. So cliff means a steep high face rock, especially at the edge of the sea. After long journey through the jungle, Sher Singh became tired. He knew that if he continues his journey without rest, he could go no further. So sweat was running off his shaking flesh all over his body. So he set his sick brother Kunwar down gently against a tree. It was then that he heard the jostle and squeal of elephants. Below him on the river bed, the elephant traveled. He could see the cows and the babies and one great old tusker. He was playing his trunk to and fro to learn whatever the breeze could tell him, and suddenly he hesitated. The trunk came round towards the boys. Sher Singh chilled with fright. With Kunwar to carry, he could neither climb nor run. The tusker snorted, trumpeted, shook his head. Suddenly, he hurried on angrily up the river bed, and all the herd went with him. They disappeared. Students, when he settled his brother down under the tree, he heard the jostle and squeal of elephants. So jostle means to push roughly against. So squeal means a high, long sound or cry, a herd of elephants pushing each other and making long sound nearby him on the river bed. The elephants are walking. He could see the cows and babies and one great old tusker. Old tusker means an old elephant. Okay. Old tusker was playing with his trunk, moving background and forward or from side to side to learn the breeze. So breeze means a gentle wind. Okay. Suddenly he hesitated. The trunk came round towards the boys. So Sher Singh chilled with fright. He shivered with cold and fear. He could not understand what to do in this moment. So neither climb nor run. The tusker snorted and trumpeted. Snorted means breathed noisily with nose. Trumpeted means made a sound loudly by elephants. So shook his head. Suddenly he moved quickly on angrily up the river bed, and all the herd went with an old tusker. So all the elephants along with old tuskers disappeared. Sher Singh breathed one more prayer of thanks this time and got ready to move with Kunwar on his back once again. He scrambled down into the river bed.
He stepped into the river. The water was cold and deep. Thank goodness, there was a bridge at the second river. It was a flimsy thing made of bamboo poles, stones, thick grass and river gravel. But it was at least a bridge. He plodded steadily on. Students, Sher Singh sighed and gratitude to the God to risked his and his brother's lives from the great Tuskers. And he continued his journey with Kunwar on his back once again. He moving against the water in the river, but it was too difficult to moving quickly in the river. He stepped his foot into the river. He feels the water was cold and deep. And he knew that the second river had a bridge, that he could go on the bridge. It was a flimsy thing made of bamboo poles, stones, thick grass and river gravel. So flimsy means damaged bridge. So gravel means the stones which we get from the rivers, but it was almost damaged. He walked with heavy steps because he was tired and moved gradually towards midnight. He heard the second river ahead of him. He heard it from far away, a steady roar of flood. When he came out on the shore, he saw it. A big head of snow must have melted yesterday, and here it was. From bank to bank, the river foamed. He looked for the bridge. It was not there. Students, so he thinks how to cross the second river. Midnight. He knew that the second river ahead of him, and he heard it from far away, a steady roar of flood. So flood means an overflow of a large amount of water beyond its normal limits. When he came out on the land, he saw it. A big herd of snow had melted the day before. From bank to bank, the river foamed. So foamed means a mass of small bubbles formed on. He looked for the bridge, but it was not there. So almost the bridge was wreckaged. Wreckage means damaged. So he thinks how to cross the second river. He has not have a chance to swim along with his brother. It would be lost in the river. It may there was a way away. Among the wreckage of the bridge, wreckage means damaged, the bridge has been damaged. Sher Singh gathered grass and plaited it into a rope. He tied the rope around his brother and himself. So they would keep together. Then he entered the water just above the bridge. It was so cold that he could hardly keep his hold. He did not know if his brother was alive or dead, but he kept the child's head above the water and inch by inch moved along. He was deaf, blinded, frozen and tired, but he went on and went on. Students, Sher Singh, he collected some grass and twisted them together and made it into a rope he had made here. Then Sher Singh tied the rope around his brother and himself, so they would keep together. Then he entered the water just above the bridge. Both of them plodded and steadily in the river. It was so cold that he could hardly
hold his brother tightly. He did not know if his brother was alive or dead. He was deaf, blinded, frozen. So deaf means lacking of power of hearing. And blind means to be unable to see. Frozen means very cold. Okay. So, but he was keep on going in the river. Then the river seemed to lose power. They were through. After that, Sher Singh did not know what happened. He was walking and walking on and on. There was a road. Then there was a better road far away in the another world. There came sounds heralding a village. Suddenly somehow people, after that, the next he knew they were in a bullock cart and then a truck. So, where have you come from, boy? Laldwani. You carried him alone across the river in flood. See, when he walking through the river disappeared, and after that he did not know what happened. He was walking on, and there was a road. Then it was better road than earlier. Far away there came sounds. He guessed that he was in a village. Suddenly the people of village carried them in a bullock cart, then a truck. The truck driver asked him that, where have you come from? The driver asked him, where have you come from? The boy answered, I came from Laldwani village. So then he asked him that, you carried him alone across the river in flood. The driver took them in his truck and left them in the hospital. Now they were at the hospital. Sher Singh always felt bashful of big buildings. Okay, he did not go in. Later, the doctor came out of the veranda and said, are you Sher Singh who brought the child in from Laldwani? The boy replied, yes, I am Sher Singh. I brought my brother from Laldwani village for treatment. So then a smile was all over the doctor's gentle face and said, Sher Singh, Bahadur, your brother is alive now. Right now he is out of danger. Come and see. So the Sher Singh went in to see his brother. So children, the moral lesson you learned today from this story is that you should never give up at the times of adversity and should always believe in your capabilities. It justifies the saying, where there is a will, there is a way. Because Sher Singh never lost his hope and determines to take his brother Kunwar to the hospital. I hope you have understood this story.